The next question I'd like to answer is, how do I know if my treatment's working? Well, because PBC is often found early by routine blood tests that might be abnormal, many patients with PBC don't feel symptoms. So we don't necessarily tell a person they're going to feel better when we're initiating therapy. Sometimes our medications actually have side effects. So while you're getting used to your medicine, you could occasionally even feel worse. So it's important to know how you're going to decide if the medicine is working for you. The most important metrics that as a clinician I follow are your biochemical responses. So most people with PBC are found to have PBC because their alkaline phosphatase or their bilirubin are elevated, or their ALT and their AST are elevated. And we absolutely understand that the closer the alkaline phosphatase and bilirubin get to normal while on therapy, the better the therapy is working. And so if you track your own numbers, that's really important. And you can see those two values start to become into that normal range. If they don't, with just our first line agent, we do have second line or alternative therapies that we can try to help push a person into biochemical remission or, lab tests that look really good. We will also intermittently look at scar tissue. So you may or may not have had a liver biopsy to confirm and stage your disease. But most of the time, a clinician will also do something like a fiber scan or MR elastography, something that looks at the amount of scar tissue in the liver tissue. And although we don't always expect that to get better with therapy, we certainly like to see it remain stable. And we always love to see things improve. And so although we don't change our management necessarily based on your fiber scan or elastography results, we're certainly going to watch that to make sure that your liver health remains in a good range and so that we understand more accurately your risk for other liver-related complications.